Hi friends, this is Sarvajan here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today I'm going to discuss about IPv6, NS and NA. So what is NA? NS is nothing but a neighbor solicitation message, and NA is a neighbor advertising messages. So this NS and NA are always exchanged between these both R1 and R2, mainly to find the link local address of this neighbor. So R1 will send a NS message to R2, and R2 will send a NA to R1. Same way, R2 again will send a NS to R1 and receive the NA from R1. That is, both NS is nothing but a neighbor solicitation message, and NA is a neighbor advertising message, which is exchanged between R1 and R2 mainly for finding the link local address of the neighbor. So that is not a routable address. This is mainly for the neighbor communication and for identifying the neighbor. So we are sending this link local address, right? So that is the reason it is exchanging NS and NA messages. So the NS messages contain information like type 135 message. That contains type 135 and the source address of the R1. It can be a link local address of R1, and the destination address will be the solicitor node multicast address. So solicitor node multicast address is a type of multicast address used to find the link local address of the neighbor. Similar way, R2 will send again the neighbor advertisement for this reply, right? Or R1 will send a NS message. So upon getting the NS message, R2 will send a neighbor advertisement message. So this carries information like type 136, source address of R2. This is a source address of R2, and the destination will be the destination address of the R1. The similar way, both NS and NA always will be exchanged between R1 and R2. So now let us go ahead and configure. Before that, let us enable the packet capture. How to do that? Go to this link, right click, start capture, and click OK. So let us run the packet capture. So I want to show this type 135 and type 136 message. So now let us go to the R1. Debug IPv6 ND. I'm enabling the neighbor discovery protocol on both R1 and R2. So debug IPv6 ND. So I'm enabling on both R1 and R2. So now what we can do, let us enable the, I already told in the previous video, so how the it will generate the link local address. First, I have to enable IPv6 enable on a specific interface. So once I enable this on the interface, what happen, automatically this will generate a link local address of this fast thread interface, and this also will simultaneously generate. So let us go ahead and do, go to the configuration mode, interface fast thread 0x0, IPv6 enable. Similar way, let us go to R2. Interface fast Ethernet 0x0, IPv6 enable. So after doing this, we need to activate the interface. So it will is in administrative shutdown mode. So we need to activate the interface, right? So go to configuration mode, interface fast Ethernet 0x0, no shut. Similar way, let us go to R2 and activate the interface. Interface fast Ethernet 0x0, no shut, right? So I activated the interface. So now let us capture the packets. So before that, let us see the messages. So I already told both will be exchanging NS and NA. So you'll be seeing both NS and NA for this link local address. You're able to see, right? This is a link local address of this fast Ethernet interface, and similarly you're seeing NA. So that's the reason I told this will send a NS message to R2 and will receive the NA message. Similarly, this will again send a NS and NA message. So that is the reason we are seeing both NS and NA for this link local address. So this link local address, the address for this corresponding fast Ethernet interface. So how to check that? Go to show IPv6 interface fast Ethernet 0x0. So you can check here, right? So the similar way, R2 also will send the information. You are able to see, right? R2 is sending both NS and NA messages. So DAD is nothing but duplicate address detection. It is used to detect any duplicate address. So it is used to check whether the each and every link local address is unique. So each and every address of R1 and R2 will be always unique. So in case if any other conflict, this is used to identify. DAD is nothing but a duplicate address detection, right? So that is the reason here you are seeing no DAD is enabled. So now let us go ahead and check the packet tracer. So how to capture the packet tracer in this IPv6, how to do that? ICMP. So I'm going to specifically capture the 135 and 136 message, that is NS and NA messages. So ICMPv6.type is equal to 135. You have to do like this, 135 or 136. Just click it. So you're able to see, right? You are able to see this neighbor solicitation messages, right? The source address is the link local address, and the destination address will be You are able to see right destination address. I already told this address what we called as a solid state node multicast address. I will explain in the other video what is exactly the solid state node multicast address. So this address is used to find the link local address of the neighbor. So this is a neighbor solid station message which carries a source address and the destination is a solid state node multicast address. And similar way, let us check the neighbor advertisement messages. 136, you will see the neighbor advertisement messages. Just double click it. So you can see here source will be the source address of this R2. So that is R2. So source address of link local address of the R2 and the destination address will be FF021. So this is nothing but all nodes. So it is sending to all nodes. That is the reason we are seeing source is the link local address and the destination again is the all node multicast address. So this is how you can see right corresponding neighbor solicitation and neighbor advertisement messages, and this is how we can capture the packet. So for a neighbor solicitation message, you type 135. You can see the neighbor solicitation packet. For neighbor advertisement, you can see 136. That is a type 136 message for a neighbor advertisement message. So this is how the neighbor solicitation and the neighbor advertisement function between R1 and R2. So this main purpose is used to find the link local address of the neighbor. So once it link local is identified, then it will automatically generate the RA, that is a R router solicitation and the router advertisement message. So that I will discuss in the next coming slide. I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me for more videos. Thank you and have a wonderful day.